acquisition, a digital readout as opposed to analog acquisition. It has to handle a range of users. So there could be, for example, if he takes it to a football team, you know, if it's test on a lineman, you could be able to test on a gymnast. Different body types need to be able to use this. It has to be easy to use, durable, it can't break. It has to have a variable load, which takes away the user bias. For example, if you put in the mouth guard, you may subconsciously push harder or increase your performance without knowing it. So there has to be a way to take away that bias somehow. And you can see in the top right, this is our initial prototype sketch that we were going to pursue. And then in the bottom right, after we were faced with the variable load idea in the middle of the semester, we had to come up with a different design. So in the bottom right, you can see the CAD drawing of our final product. And this measures strength.
Now we're going to take you guys through a video of the prototype functioning. This is a close-up view of the product. You can see the spring damper system there, and they're adjustable with threads individually on each one, which gives you a range of possibilities for a variable load. And there's a load cell and another handle, a data acquisition board, a signal amplifier, and data acquisition software. So now we will show you a live stream demo, so you'll be able to see the data picked up by the computer. There are two different main ways to compress the device. These are just the first two we use, are horizontal and vertical. Vertical does a little more balanced testing. So if you can see, it's kind of faint with the lighting, but there is readout going to the computer, and you see peaks and valleys plotted, which is the output voltage from the load cell. And that is then converted to pounds with the calibration that we did.
Given more time, we'd like to make a few small changes to the device, including the sliding mechanism. Right now it's a threaded rod, and we think that it would be best to remove those threads. We also would like to add a mechanism to more quickly adjust that variable load so that it could be done between tests without the user noticing. Furthermore, we'd like to automate the data collection so that a real-time force output could be read by the user. And this we would do using an Arduino board so that we could convert the voltage from the load cell to a force automatically. We did see an 11% increase in force output using the mouth guard, and so we think that it would definitely be worthwhile to pursue clinical testing or even take this device to conferences, out to the football field, and test it on a number of Dr. Zubas's patients and customers. Thank you.
You think 11% is statistically significant? Did you
It's hard to say because, you know, we designed them. So any test that we do is subject to a little bit more bias than even the user bias who knows about the mouth guard. So while we saw that, it's hard to say if we tried on someone who hasn't.
Well,
that's
how many people you tested.
So that's why we would suggest that you know clinical testing should be used.
Okay, guys. I just want to thank Dr. Zubas.